Hey guys.
Hey everybody. Welcome back to GDPG. What?
No, I feel like we're both like
who's gonna start?
Hey you guys.
So today we're playing Cat Lateral Damage, which has been out for a little while. Whoa. I mean, copyright's what, 2013 through 2015, so I assume they ran the Kickstarter 2013 and released early 2015?
Yeah, we went through the credits and it turns out that we're guessing the Kickstarter rewards were the titles that you get in the credits, and they were like Hipster Cats, Lol Cats, Lol Dogs, like it was cute. But this is made by Chris Chung, and it is a Firehose Games Accelerator collaboration. Those are words that I don't use on an everyday basis.
It's true.
Accelerator collaboration.
Fancy words.
Okay.
You should jump in. So we're gonna play. Kujo's playing, and we're doing what, objective mode? I assume that's the main game. Litterbox is probably like a sandbox where we can just break everything.
Let's learn how to play Cat Lateral Damage.
Look at that goofy cat face.
Oh. Whoa!
Except
I am the cat.
Cats? Have you? Let me restart. Have you ever owned a cat?
Yes. Yeah. Absolutely. I had 4 cats at one point.
Oh, nice! Wow, yeah, that's pretty on par with me.
Oh, the jump height,
dude.
Oh, the crosshairs is a cat face.
Like the cat jowls and nose.
So left. Okay, so it controls the left paw.
Oh, okay, so if you click left, you sweep right.
Yes.
Okay.
And if you click right, you sweep left.
I think that makes sense.
Yeah, if they did it the other way around, my brain would
It would be confusing, right?
Yeah.
At least
sparkly pot. Oh, no. All right, cat.
Well, the sparkles are everything. It's all the objective points, right? So that means if it sparkles, we can break it. Get the picture frame.
Oh, there's a... Oh.
It's Nibby.
Oh, Nibby.
That's the cat that we're...
Whoa. Look at Nibby. Oh, I want a cat again. I want a cat so bad. You have no idea.
No, I understand.
The jump because it's so crazy is actually a little difficult to control, but not like it's badly mechanic. It's like a bad mechanic. It actually is well done. It's just kind of like culture shock to me right now.
Do you think that it's? Do you think it would be?
Oh. Yeah!
Wow!
Oh, I want a cat!
So do you
Shut up, I like cats, internet.
Have you been on the internet? Everybody loves cats. That's true. Except for not cat
Billions
people.
Billions of people like cats. Favorite object.
Isn't there a theory that cat poop carries some sort of virus? Or like viral infection? That I don't know, some sort of chemical component that makes you like cats more? But the thing about it is, if you get it, and it's like a virus, right? And so it becomes hardwired in your DNA, and you can pass that like down to your children. And so what if we've been indoctrinated by the cats, and that's why we love them so much?
I feel like this is a bad like science fiction novel.
That's a real theory I've heard. I don't obviously know very much about it, but it's...
Fuck your plan!
It's funny...
And your picture of me.
It's funny when...
Or of another...
Is that a...
That's
another
cat.
I wonder if we can, like, swap out our cat with other cats.
That might... Oh,
unlockable cats.
Oh, alright.
I'm actually... So I've been curious about this game for a while. I remember when I...
What? How do I... What do I do? Do I just
is it
stick around with it?
Maybe... Oh!
What is that?
It's a...
Jumping priest. What? That's awesome! That's adorable.
You can break even more!
Yes!
So I guess
Fuck you, humans!
The design is sort of like a puzzle game, then.
Yeah,
in a way.
It's a puzzle game with a little bit of an upgrade system, which is cool. I approve of that. I think that's cool. It keeps a game varied.
Event?
What? What? Moon gravity. Oh! Oh! This is adorable and awesome! Oh my god!
Wow.
I am... Oh, man. Oh, that's kind of like a blessing and a curse, because it's all supposed to land on the ground, not on other objects.
You know, this is actually...
Can I jump on that? Oh, my God.
You can jump off of it?
Oh, my God, that's cool! Oh, this is awesome.
That is actually... That's really...
That's
really ridiculous.
I feel like a ninja now.
You basically are a moon ninja. I mean, cats are ninjas, ninja so... Cat. Moon ninja cat.
There's so much stuff! Whoa, your DVDs are mine!
So it's like a puzzle...
All your DVDs in which the covers look like they were designed in MS Paint. Sorry.
Puzzle sandbox cat simulator.
Yes, absolutely.
What an interesting concept.
Yeah.
I guess, I mean,
this
obviously,
is awesome.
I feel like the concept of the game started with the developers saying, we want to make a game where you're the cat, right? That's a very, very clear, like, high concept design or, like, theme to start with. Dude. So then I guess it was like, what was the next step in the design? Do you think it was like, well, what do cats do? They knock shit off of things.
I feel like the first step was actually getting the movement speed and the jump height and the maneuverability down.
Well,
that, I feel like that's always something to keep... I don't know, maybe
well,
that's just coming from...
That's me. Like fine-tuned mechanics. That's something that just comes with, like, the design of, you are a cat. Well, then the next question is, well, how does a cat move? How do we make it feel like a cat and feel fun?
Do I do everything in here?
But I don't think you generally think about those... You shouldn't think about those things in the high concept phase. Oh, you can break more stuff. So I've been curious about this game for a long time too. I actually don't know how many levels there are, so I don't know how suitable this is for a
single
episode playthrough.
We'll figure it out. I mean,
we'll at least play through most of the game, I'd say.
Yeah.
We've got a timer going. I doubt we'll go over an hour.
No. Fuck your towels?
T-shirts?
T-shirt towels?
Maybe they're like jerseys?
This is
maybe
ridiculous.
They're towels.
I'm gonna go home and I'm gonna, like, right before I go to sleep, I'm gonna be like, well, what did I do today? I went to work.
Oh, you're running out of time.
Oh,
dude, you gotta hurry
time.
Up.
Oh shit.
This ain't a
okay,
walk
well,
in a park.
All right.
You're a cat on a mission. Fuck, dude.
I'm shut up.
There's so much stuff to break. Quit chit chat.
Shut up. Oh my god. I have a 10 seconds.
What was our objective? What was
We have to knock off all of the objects, all 190
objects. Well, why are there 3 books and 9 other books on the...
Oh, maybe...
Oh, you. I think you had to knock...
point values.
No, I think you had to knock... Oh, you're right. And, okay.
Books give you times 3.
So we needed 190 points, and the... Oh, and that breaks down everything. So, did you only get points from the books?
I don't think...
Oh,
you look veiny.
He's a tabby cat.
I know. Oh, I'm totally going with Lynn. Oh, well, Lynn or Nippy?
I like Nippy the best.
Nippy. We'll go with Nippy.
He's got that, like, silly cat face.
Yeah.
You know that face that cats make when they, like, smell something funny and they kind of curl one lip?
Oh.
It's like...
Oh, real quick. I'm going to do this, tell the story as best I can.
Okay,
450
first...
objects.
And
bonus.
You want thing. Sheets and pillows? Not pillows. I don't know what that is. It looks like a whipped cream pie.
So one of my cats, Allie, I wonder if I told the story on here.
I don't think you've told any stories about your cats on the show.
So she was the most social out of all of them. And at one point I was sitting like watching TV and she had come up and like laid on my lap and fell asleep. Cool. I realized she'd fallen asleep. So at one point while I'm watching TV, I, like, remember that she's on my lap, and I look down, and I'm gonna do this as quickly as I can, because it's got a 10-minute timer that's more than enough time for me to do this. I look down, and my cat had fallen asleep with her eyes open, and she was looking at me like this. And the sun was shining through the window, and it made her eyes, it made her pupils, like, go small and like slanty, and I legitimately got scared.
Dude, cats are creepy. Nathan was telling me that cats, they can see more spectrum of light than humans can.
That's not surprising.
So yeah, it's really not, but oftentimes there'll be cats just like staring off at a wall, just like totally just like involved in that wall.
Yeah.
And Nathan's theory is that they're just seeing like crazy shit happening with colors, and they're just like, my god, it's beautiful.
They're beautiful.
those are the only mechanics missing from this game. We should be able to poop and pee on things and cough
and
on
barf.
Fireballs.
Don't forget barfing.
But I've grown up my whole life with cats.
Oh! Second upgrade.
So playing with cat toys seems to give you upgrades.
What is this? SWAT?
SWAT.
Oh, so my strength goes up?
Whoa! Do you see your little, like, cat face cursor? It changed when you were swatting. It's all like, hurrah! Maybe it was when you were hitting things.
Alright.
It's like, fangy mouth. Like, cat being angry, being all like, hinga!
New photo unlocked. It's so easy to, like, forget where you're... Where, like, the edge of the shelf is.
Yeah, that's kind of fair. Well, that's why the shelves are what would you call it? Like stacked, staggered. They're staggered out, right?
Yeah.
So you could go all the way to the left on one, or all the way on one end, and then you can jump on it.
Think about that.
Jeez, Cujo, is this your first 3D platformer?
My first 3D platformer that's also a cat simulator? Yes. Yes, it is.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I'd have a hard time playing this game, because I would want to look at everything. I've seen so many little boxes with, like, art on it.
Yeah.
I'm like, what is it?
Whoa.
Oh, shit.
I broke the TV.
A power-up has appeared.
Where?
It's in the other room.
Where the hell? Oh. Like, where the hell is that?
What the heck? Oh, there's more rooms than I thought. Oh, there's so much stuff to break. Yes.
What did I get?
Catnip?
Oh!
Star power!
Oh, everything is broken. Everything is going to die. It's super
so
cat mode. Oh my gosh.
So this is the, like, motion sick.
I never understood catnip. I don't understand why that's, like, a thing.
I don't actually know.
I'm getting a headache.
It legitimately does mess with a cat's brain. Yeah, maybe we should put up, like, a seizure warning or something.
Yeah. Alright, back to normal. Back to breakage.
Go from room to room, just swat as much that are, like, grouped together as possible.
Oh, yeah.
And move on to the next room until you've taken out the biggest clusters and you just focus on all the little stuff. It's like Katamari Damacy, man.
There's so much stuff!
It'd be really unfortunate if the stove was on.
That's a dark thing to say, Chris. What are you saying?
I'm just saying, I've owned cats. I know what stupid shit they do.
They will obey me.
I think in my entire life, I've owned about 12 cats.
Yeah.
Something like that. The most I've ever had at one point was 6. It's because one of our cats got pregnant.
6?
Yeah, and had just a ton of babies.
Aww.
And we only kept, like, 2 of them, but at that point we already had 4 cats, so...
Oh my...
We were like, we don't really want to have 10 cats, right, all at the same time.
My friend Brian lives out in Indiana, and he lives on basically, like, farmland. There are 2 cats that they own and live on the inside of the house, one of which was a rescue. And then there are, like, 4 of them.
Oh.
Ooh.
Sorry, continue your story.
Oh, you're cool. And there are, like, 4 that live on the outside. And they... Oh.
Outdoor cats are actually really fun.
Yeah. And apparently, 2 of them had kittens together.
Oh.
And I was leaving... Brian's place one time, and oh my god, this little kitten was the cutest thing I think I'd ever seen, and I wanted to take him home. Then I remembered cats piss, shit, barf everywhere.
Well, especially if they haven't been neutered, then they're like, this is my territory.
Yeah. What happened to the... Oh, is that another one over there?
There's a power-up in that thing. In the little mini shopping cart?
Where? What?
Look, yeah, there.
Supermarket?
Marquette? A mouse is loose. Oh, shit, yeah.
Where?
I love these little events. It's probably not in this room. I don't think it's in this room. Hurry, Cujo, you only have 48 seconds. I don't think it's in this room either. Keep going. Why'd you have to put so much stuff on the floor?
Shh. That's my job.
Oh, there it is!
I have you now.
Oh, we got a new cat. And a power-up. Wait, come on. I hope we don't have to meet the score and get all of those objects.
That'd be a dick move.
Would it though?
Yeah.
Is it really asking that much design wise?
I mean,
I don't think so.
With the controls, yeah. Like, this is the challenge right now. Ooh. I cannot get.
Yeah, maybe
there.
Having max speed was not the best thing.
Did I do it?
I don't think you need anything up there. Get some of those other white plates.
Oh man. Oh no.
Oh, you get an upgrade from that.
Well, I'm gonna lose.
Nah, man. You got this. Go for bigger clusters. What is it?
SWAT.
Sweet.
Oh, nope. Nope.
New room. You gotta go to a new room.
I have 13 seconds.
Yeah, you could still do it. You never know. You're maxed out, man. Oh, look at that. Get that shelf. Oh, why haven't you been in here?
No!
All right.
We got
home. New cat. I wonder if the cats have different...
Nero! Kratos. The angriest looking cat. And Magoo. And I know these are actual, like, cats. We're gonna go with Kratos.
It's a pretty good name for a cat.
Yeah. So I think objective mode is just a way for you to unlock more cats.
Well, yeah, I think objective mode is the main point of the game. Oh, yeah, there's no level select mode, but they have new areas. Because we unlocked the Super Marquette.
Yeah, okay.
Wait, can we go to the Super Marquette?
Did you see that?
What?
One of the objects, the plant, or the pot,
yeah.
Knocked it over, gave me 7 points.
Oh,
so
okay,
that
nice.
Is a... what were you saying? Marquette?
Oh, I see. It's... So, the pot on the left, that's telling you that that's the bonus item. That gives you extra points.
Yeah.
The one on the right, the I guess the books, if you get all those, then you get a free power-up.
Got it. Okay.
I think they could have had some sort of, like, I don't know, icon or a word there to help explain that, but...
Well, the way they explain it is when you...
Yeah,
you hit them.
You figure it out by doing.
Oh.
So it's actually kind of intuitive still. I think I probably would have put like a power up. Well, I don't know. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's cleaner this way, right?
Honestly, because you're gonna want to knock everything down anyway, so I don't really think.
So it basically just it subtly leads you, but at the end of the day, it doesn't really change that much.
What? Kill the glowing red dots.
Dude, these events are perfect.
No, it's around. It's another room.
How much fun do you think it would have been to make this game?
Oh, man, it must have been awesome.
Like,
I'm actually a little upset I wasn't able to be involved.
I know, right? And, I mean, gameplay-wise, it probably wasn't that difficult to program. I bet things like the events were probably the... Well...
Oh,
yeah.
We'll have you.
I bet the events were probably the tougher thing to program.
Power up.
Or maybe the power-ups. By the way, like, the core mechanics are super simple, right?
Yeah.
And, like, even the art for this is nice and simple. It's,
yeah, and it doesn't need to be anything else.
No, I don't think it should be anything else. It actually reminds me a lot of Katamari Damacy in its art style, because it's very, like, flat colors, very, like, polygonal art, which I love. I actually met a guy at the MGDS... the Midwest Game Developer Summit that made art like this.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, like polygonal 3D art.
My cat OJ. And before you guys ask,
orange juice?
No.
Is that what you were gonna say?
It was going to involve this. OJ was a chocolate speckled cat with one white paw. So we named her OJ. As in Simpson.
Oh, okay.
That was the joke. And my mom felt bad about doing that later, so we named her Olivia June. Whatever. It was her excuse. and it was awesome. I loved Olivia. Olivia was my cat. She was my love. Because...
I know how that goes.
She knew how to open my door. When I'm... She timed it perfectly. I'd be maybe 3 to 5 seconds from falling asleep. And then here comes OJ, creepily opening my door. I remember this happening when I was in junior high. And I was terrified. I was like, Yeah, it was exactly that. It was exactly that slow, creepy,
door
creaking sound.
They don't open doors like humans were. They're just like, wow, I'm in.
Nope. Not at all. And I remember being frozen still. Wondering,
what is
like,
in my house? What's in my room?
And then I hear,
oh, you can open the oven. What's in there? Holy shit. Cooked cat. Oh, there's nothing.
This is an unexciting oven.
Probably open the fridge.
Oh, I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, boy. So speaking of your... Oh, yeah. So going off of your story, I have a cat story too, similar to that. Back when I lived with my parents, and back when I had like six or so cats, I lived in the basement, and it was one of those rooms where they have those kind of like, what are they made out of? Like that plastery kind of tile that you put on ceilings?
Oh, yeah. Oh, my basement has it.
Yeah, and there was a whole section right by the wall where they were just missing. And it was because we put up a pseudo wall to basically separate the utility room from the basement.
Damn.
And that way, you know, the cats weren't like, the litter box wasn't in my room. But there was the space in the ceiling where the cats could like jump up into the ceiling and they'd go into my room. And so when I would have people over or something, they'd hear like things crawling around in the ceiling. And they're like, what is that? Is there an animal up there? And I was like, oh, I have ceiling cats.
Like you do.
Like you do. And people are like, what does that mean? Like, I have cats in my ceiling. What? It was the worst, though, when I was younger and I'd play horror games. So I'd like...
Oh, you'd scare the shit out of yourself.
Yeah, I'd have the volume cranked up. I'd have all the lights off. And then I'd hear something fall out of the ceiling. I'd be like, oh, God, vent monsters.
I scared my friend Casey so hard that she...
Why are you wasting your time with silverware?
I have two objects left.
Oh, touché.
Damn it.
You can't...
Stupid chair.
There you go.
Yeah! Upgrade. Jump increased.
Get in.
I wonder if the...
The box.
Because why would it give me an upgrade for completing the objectives?
I wonder if it carries over. That might have just been the item you hid.
Oh, maybe.
I don't know.
But no, my friend Casey was playing Doom 3. And she was in a room where she had no light, she had a pistol, and there were a bunch of zombies.
Oh, we're at the supermarket.
Is this it?
Oh, no, it's not. It's like a log cabin?
Yeah, cats in log cabins. Duh. No, I'm just kidding. Anyway, so she was terrified. So I snuck up behind her. And you know how, like, certain desks, like computer desks, will have, like, that slide-out drawer where you put your keyboard? Okay. I snuck up behind her, and I did this. And she freaked out, kicked that drawer, broke it, keyboard fell down, she swung her arm back, hit me in the nuts, and I was down for the count.
I mean, I'm inclined to say you had it coming.
But it was amazing. Like, everything all at once, and it was awesome.
I mean, that kind of shit's my favorite thing to do to cats. You know, I pick... Not to sound like I abuse animals or anything, but, like, I love picking on my pets.
Yeah.
Just because they're so goofy and they don't really understand anything.
Yeah, it's true, they don't.
And that's why I love having dogs, because they can roughhouse. And it's like, I'm not being mean, they love playing around.
Yeah.
But cats, they're so, like, sinister that I don't feel bad being mean to them in mean ways. So one of my favorite things to do is to sneak up on a cat and just, like, go, gah! And grab it. And just, like, see how high I can get a cat to jump.
Oh.
It's so funny, though.
Force field?
What?
Oh,
you just, like, break everything you touch? Except for the...
Oh, my God, this is awesome!
Except you're wasting your power-up! Or are you?
It is time.
Whoa! You were dragging the toilet paper with your force field, I guess. Is it timed?
Probably.
Maybe it's not. I don't know. I mean, your time in this level is pretty short.
Yep.
Oh, yeah, there it goes. Oh, Cat Donald, go inside. Go inside. Oh, yeah.
Oh, I wanted to walk around.
Cujo, you don't have time to fuck around.
I can sort of do it. It's working.
I guess it is sort of working.
Yeah. The video of cats getting scared by, like, they're eating and...
Oh, and they put a cucumber.
They're so funny. I loved it.
I saw a reenactment of it called, like, Scientists versus Cucumbers. And they did the same thing, except they had, like, human beings in lab coats. Presumably they were scientists, and they were just like, they thought it was funny, so they wanted to goof around too.
Yeah.
And they like would have someone put a cucumber up behind them, and when the scientists would turn around, they'd go like, oh god, and freak out and like jump inside a refrigerator or something. It was a pretty ridiculous video.
I don't know why that became a thing, but hey, whatever.
Damn it. The cucumbers?
They're landing perfectly on top of this couch.
Be a better cat. That's all I got.
Cool. All right, I gotta hurry.
There's totally a new room you haven't been to yet.
Where?
Go all the way back through.
I don't have the time. 10 seconds. No, it's not happening.
Ah, Cujo.
Oh, man.
What did I tell you?
Damn it. Oh, well.
Can I take a spin?
Sure.
I'm sick and tired of this place. Time to make it a mess. Got that right, Nero.
Yes, that is, yes. 410 objects in 9.5 minutes.
Plants. Bam. Easy to find. Easy peasy.
20 points? Oh, screw you.
Yeah, boy. I got the skills to pay the bills with. Can you swat? Oh, you can't swat with both paws.
No. You can headbutt.
You can head.
I mean, you what?
What? What?
Are you holding? Oh, my God. You're doing the actual, like... That's awesome. That's adorable. Alright. I'm a little mad I didn't realize that was a thing. Is it the mouse? Is it the wheel?
That's the middle mouse.
Gotcha. That's awesome.
Yeah.
You have to hit the roll, not the...
Oh, man. There we go.
Toilet paper for days! Event.
Oh, wait,
you still didn't activate it.
Power outage. What is... Is that it?
Is even color?
There we go.
Is not a thing anymore, or...?
Yeah, I don't know. It's only for the 30 seconds. Makes me wonder if it actually affects anything. So these are the upgrades you've gotten, and then this is just how it affects the stats. Wow! Your skills can get crazy!
That's ridiculous. I don't know that I like... If I like the fact that when the upgrades, like, are revealed... That you have to break it open.
Yeah, I guess that is a little weird, right? Like, why is it in a box? Why isn't it just sitting there? I already got it. Why are you... Like,
I already fulfilled a requirement. Why are you making it more difficult?
Yeah, that is kind of weird, actually. I would like to know why they did that. Like, it could be a physics thing, right? Because as soon as we break the box, they just kind of, like, fall to the ground and they don't move around.
Yeah.
So maybe it's their method of preventing it from, like, getting places where it shouldn't be? But I feel like that's a little far-fetched.
Yeah.
Oh, I wish I could stick out both paws. Wait, could I do... No.
How would you... How would you move?
I don't know. I didn't make the game.
Actually, no. That's true. They could have done that because there are videos of cats when they're freaking out that stand on their two back legs, back paws, and lose their shit for a second. So.
I love that. It's like when cats get into, like, hyper mode.
Yeah.
Of, like, I need to kill everything.
Death. 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 Death.
What do you think it
is? Metal music just starts playing like crazy.
I've seen metal music to those videos, actually.
Yeah.
What do you think it is that sets off cats like that, that make them go, like, just apeshit crazy?
I don't know. I got nothing. Cats are weird creatures.
They're so easy to rile up, too. All you have to do is, like, scratch their butt really fast.
Yep.
And then they're just and like, they're I need to kill everything!
Yeah.
Like, wow, this was... This escalated very quickly, but, you know, alright, I guess.
Yeah.
Good thing you're small, because you can't destroy very much.
So what's weird here, and this is what sort of throws me... Oh, well, it's a free... Well, no, okay. So you complete the objectives. However, you still get an upgrade thing, which begs the question. Do the upgrades become somewhat permanent?
Well, there's one way to find out. You didn't check it at...
Not get them?
No, just check it at the next level. Look. Okay. Level 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh.
Jeez, Cujo, where you been? Boom, look. So they do carry over.
200 objects, 4.5 minutes.
Psh, done. Easy peasy. Look at that monster? I don't know what that was.
What was the Rugrats?
Reptar?
Reptar.
Hell yeah, dude.
Reptar mixed with Mike Wazowski.
That was!
Mike Wazowski!
Oh, that was another good one.
Bucks Paradise. Box Paradise.
Living in a kitten's paradise.
That's a terrible joke.
You're a terrible joke. Alright, you have 3 minutes and 16 seconds.
Easy peasy. Oh my god, disco.
Disco!
Holy shit,
disco. Even outside, it is a disco sent by God above. It's a disco, not techno.
It was the techno of their day.
That's true. Oh, wow, having the disco.
This is really hard.
Oh. Oh, someone was doing beer pong.
Not anymore, bitches.
Bitches! Why would you set up a full thing of beer pong
and just leave it there? I don't know, man. Sometimes it's nice to be prepared ahead of time. Maybe they were
setting up. Yeah, setting up for a party. Hey, Chris, you missed it. No, you can't. Nope. Nope. It's too late. It's too late to apologize. It's too late.
I never liked you as a person.
I never liked you. And it said, I just sneezed like you, Dad. And my dad's like, what does that mean? And
what does that mean?
Yeah. And my brother was like, well, you have two different sneezes. And he took the time to spell these out, which was what really made me laugh. Now, when my dad sneezes, he'll do the achoo, like the normal sneeze. That's
you know,
achoo.
The mechanic.
Then he will, because you always sneeze in twos, sometimes threes.
People are weird.
Yeah. He has this weird, like, not like a tick, but like this last minute thought of, nope, gotta mix it up. And he'll go, Hepsi!
What?
Yeah.
Hepsi!
Hepsi!
Shit.
And then there's the last one. Once again, my brother took the time to spell this out. A fwob!
A fwob?
I don't know why it's so funny to me. So
if I ever meet your dad, I'm gonna be like, so I hear you sneezing.
So my dad was like, oh, good for you, glad it's
boom,
carrying over, or
boom,
something like that. And later on at night I realized every single person in my family has a weird sneeze. We don't have a sneeze that's like, oh, just bless you, and
well,
we just leave it at that.
I think that's pretty normal among a lot of people, actually. I feel like sneeze is a very personal thing.
Yeah.
You gotta craft it in your own way, you know?
Yeah. It reveals who you are as a person.
Yeah, man.
Like,
I know people that when they sneeze, you basically go deaf forever.
Yep. My aunt.
Yeah. And like when I sneeze, I just like, I get it all out. I'm just like,
yeah.
I don't care what's in my way.
So like that's the thing about sneezes though, is that it's your body getting stuff out.
Right,
It's your nose being like, get this out of my face.
Well, that's my logic. That's why I'm like,
right.
Why hold it back? Just
okay.
Let all that shit
so,
out.
So
spray
that actually factors
everyone.
In. That actually factors in. So when I was a kid, my dad rarely yelled. Rarely did anything.
What kind of child?
Volume.
That explains a lot about you.
Rarely did anything loud or
hardened
anything like
to
that.
The world.
I shut up. So
jaded.
As a kid, whenever I'd hear him sneeze, I hear him go, "That's true." I felt fear. There was fear in my heart because I was like, "What? Something's wrong. Something happened."
Cujo, you were like a cat. You were just like, "What was that? Oh god." Hold on 1 second. I didn't break the mouse. I didn't break it. It just exploded a little bit.
It's like the best possible thing that could have happened. It's a genuine unconscious thought of I'm not gonna let go of the mouse when I do this.
Well, no, that's not even what it was. Oh. I went to go for the motion, and my hand still was cupping the mouse, and I didn't release before I moved my arm, and I was like, oh, there's no going back now. And it even took me a second to register. I'm actually happy we caught that on camera, because now I can look back and see exactly how long it took me to realize that the mouse was no longer in my hand.
Oh, so good. Are you in a cat paradise here?
It's the box paradise.
Oh.
Come on, Gujo, where you been?
Shut up. So, yes, you could say that I was a cat. I freak out, I throw mice, you know, that's what I did as a kid.
Yeah, Cujo, I am literally inside a box castle.
Oh my gosh.
This is what it's like. This is amazing. I want to be a cat.
You should sign up to be the actor in the next ad that they do for this game, because that was awesome. Oh, oh no. When you sneeze, there's all that force, right?
Right.
Get it, like you're getting it out. My mom sneezes like this.
Oh no, that's how you give yourself a stroke. I'm not even kidding.
I know.
It's so bad.
I keep telling her, like, just get it out. And she has. She has. Mom, if you're watching this, your sneezes have improved. She now does this. And it's going somewhere, and that's fine.
Yeah. Cat's in the bag. Hey, you get it? Because it's a cat game. And I've got the cat in the bag because I'm the cat. And
you're also not able to get to the fucking shelf that you've been trying to...
It's hard, all right? You try living in from the perspective of a cat. It's not easy. I don't know why these fuckers are so crazy.
Are you a cat advocate now?
Jesus.
Cats don't get enough respect.
They don't. They work so hard every day, night after night. No one shows them any goddamn respect around here.
What the fuck is happening?
I don't know.
What has this game done to us? When I was younger, we had a cat named Chloe. And,
I don't want to go faster. I'm already going so fast. I'm getting vomity.
My brother and I were hanging out, and eventually he's like, oh, Joe, watch this. He's like, okay. He goes up and crawls up real slow on Chloe. And she knows he's there. But he goes... And you just see the fear set in. Her head slinks back into her shoulders and immediately is like...
In the cat?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Chloe was like, get the hell away from me, you demon. Like.
But why?
Because, well, have you ever noticed that whenever cats are like fighting each other, before they collide, their meows get really crazy?
These are two cats.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought this was a human and a cat. And
yeah,
I was like...
No, it was. My brother made that sound and freaked my cat out.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. I like that.
See what I mean?
I
it's so fun to mess with cats.
Yeah.
Sweat.
Sweat.
My sweat's increased. So, I feel like it's kind of nice that they let you just, like, hang out after you beat a level and collect all the upgrades that you missed.
That is pretty sweet.
Especially, like, I guess it's sort of a way to make sure that you have enough power-ups to survive the next level?
Oh, that's true.
But at the same time, now I don't want to leave until I've gotten all of them. Which, I guess in a sandbox, it's... You know, if this game wasn't a sandbox, then I wouldn't like that.
Yeah.
But because it is, I'm not disappointed. Dude, I'm rocking this.
Shut up. You get it. You're good at this game.
So much better than you. Dude, I'm just a better cat. What can I say? Meow.
Oh, man. Which stage is this for?
For ya. I think this is the last one. Wall of Love. Whoa! Whoa! Whoa!
What?
Whoa! 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 Rainbow! This is Bit Trip Runner, I think, isn't it? It totally is!
Oh, cool! Moon Gravity!
Yeah, buddy!
There are white plates below this one.
Right, you got that right, buddy.
Yeah, buddy.
Yeah, buddy. You know, if I ever work on a bigger budget indie game, because I've made my fair share of, like, shitty little ones, I totally want to have, like, fun shout-outs to a lot of the other indie games that I love.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh, Museum. Is it the
Meowsium.
Meowsium? I was hoping it'd be like M-E-W, the museum. Oh, it is!
Museum, ah! You're right. Damn it. I'm just... I suck.
It's okay. We can't all be fantastic hats. Oh, I have to get...
You have $281,000!
In property.
Oh, damage. Now I understand. Wait. Why is...
Dude, this game is totally inspired by Katamari Damacy, because Katamari, so it had the core mechanics, right?
Mm-hmm.
And every level or now and then, they would just switch things up, and it'd be like, now you have to get a fire Katamari, you have to keep the flames going, otherwise you lose.
Yeah.
So now it's like, oh, you have to break more expensive things to win. At least, I
kind of like that, because now certain objects have value. It's not just an object falling on the ground.
And it now, changes the way you think about it,
exactly.
Too. You go for what you think might be the most expensive pieces.
Yeah, it really gives you that idea of going for the big clusters of stuff, because they might not be worth a lot, but together they are worth something. That's awkward.
This is like my Saiyan punch. Ha! Oh.
Especially when you miss. Like Krillin did all the time with his goddamn destructive disc.
You know, I watched the Dragon Ball Z Abridged.
Oh, yeah?
And it really puts it in perspective just how much Krillin sucks.
Yup.
Poor Krillin. I love that series, by the way. When you finally got me to sit down and watch it, the next week I had already got caught up.
Good.
It's just like, oh.
They're doing Final Fantasy VII Abridged.
Yeah, I started watching that. I actually don't like that one as much, but it still is pretty funny.
Their later episodes are pretty good.
I'm also... maybe this is not going to be a popular opinion, but I'm not as big of a fan of Final Fantasy VII as I think a lot of people are. Like, it's good, don't get me wrong.
Yeah.
I every time I've tried to go back and replay it... Whoa, that's weird. I've had a hard time... really enjoying it. Maybe I'm just accustomed to modern game mechanics where...
Well, remember, Final Fantasy VII was in the era of the turn-based RPG.
Right, and that was before grinding started getting weeded out of games, too.
Exactly. So, remember that those games, while yes, grinding was a thing that you did kind of need to do from time to time...
And not always,
but... It didn't have a lot of crazy... there was stuff to, like, go after, like, the materia and such, but in terms of, like, crazy mechanics, it didn't really have a whole lot. The big hook for that was the story, and when we were that age, when we saw Sephiroth for the first time, I lost my shit, because I was like, what the hell is that?
That's you fair. Know?
So I think it's more... it made so much money... was because it was more like it had a really cool story to it. It wasn't the best story ever told in Final Fantasy, by
any
means.
I think since then there have been better stories. But I think the story was one of the main driving points. I think it was one of the first 3D games. Maybe one of the first 3D RPGs.
Yeah.
I don't remember because I was sort of out of that world.
Actually, that might be the case, yeah. Because I'm thinking of like. All the other Final Fantasies up until that point, and they were all 2D and Super Nintendo and Standard Nintendo.
Oh, yeah, no, it was a huge deal when that Final Fantasy came out because it was 3D.
Mm.
And it was on the original PlayStation 2, which that was even kind of unheard of at that time.
Yeah, that's true.
And
then that spawned Legend of Dragoon and several other RPGs.
Yeah, I actually played a lot of Legend of Dragoon, too, and I enjoyed that, but...
I need to finish that one.
It's so long. I really like the active RPG mechanics, though.
Yeah, I liked having the
timing.
The timing, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that was cool, too. I thought the music was pretty cool back in the day for that game.
Oh, yeah.
Mostly because it was, like, a minor upgrade from Final Fantasy VII.
Oh. You know I gotta... This cat is so strong.
Fuck this T-Rex. I'm the
that
king.
That just got you, like, a shit ton of money.
That's why you can't dwindle, man. All the good shit is in the future rooms. Sorry, I didn't
mean
totally
fine.
To stop you.
But Legend of Dragoon, I think it came out, like, a couple of years after Final Fantasy VII.
So it had like the similar sort of character model look, if not being updated a little bit. The story and it and the script were they were good, but there were points where I was like, wow, the tropes. Oh, the tropes.
Yeah.
But the music and certain like effects in the game were a little updated, so I have more. It's weird, but I have more fond memories of that game than I do Final Fantasy VII because I had more stuff to do.
That may be another unpopular opinion.
Yeah, probably. And by all means, am I saying Final Fantasy VII is a bad game? I loved it. I loved it when I was a kid. I loved Tifa because she was just a hand-to-hand fighter.
And you're gay, so you didn't like her because she was busty.
Right. I just liked her because she was a badass.
Which, I appreciate that.
Yeah. But no, Legend of Dragoon, it just felt like I had more stuff to latch onto. Getting the dragon powers and turning into a dragoon, that was the coolest thing in my mind. Oh, how long does this game go?
I think there are 6 stages right now, so this might be the last one. I thought there were 4 originally.
There were. And then he went and unlocked Museum or whatever.
I mean, I'll give them that for a Kickstarter game. I don't think they ask for a lot of money either. I think they are pretty good at reusing their content. Because it's like we see a lot of the same art assets.
Yeah.
And the environments aren't, you know, super crazy different. Like that last one was pretty much the most different that we've seen yet.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I guess, and box.
The log cabin.
Paradise. No, the box paradise.
Oh, yeah.
I think those two were probably the most unique as far as assets go.
Mm.
But yeah, I think I'm not unsatisfied with them reusing assets because
no, it's fine.
It still is fun. And the mechanics change a little bit.
Yeah.
But if you were to have made this game, right, say you were given the high concept of, you know, we're making a game where it's basically a cat simulator.
Mm-hmm.
What would you do? Like, how would you design it?
I don't know. You're asking me to be the dev here, and that's not... I don't know.
I'm not asking you to be the dev. I'm just asking you, design-wise, like, what do you think you would have wanted in a cat simulator?
Pooping, peeing, barfing. No.
I mean, that would have been funny, but I feel like it also would have been gotten gross quick, you know?
Yeah. Honestly, this, there's no, like, honestly, I mean that sincerely, I don't really think there's any better, like, way to illustrate the ridiculousness of cats in a cat sim than this game. I mean, this would probably be the most fun way to have a cat simulator, and I don't know, there wouldn't be anything I would do differently.
I actually pretty much agree with you there. If I were to have designed this game, I probably would have done it similarly. And I think the probable Katamari Damacy inspiration comes off very, very well. And there really is no better inspiration that I can think of for a game like this.
Yeah.
Because it has a similar kind of humor and absurdity to it, you know?
Yeah.
I think the only thing that I might have changed is movement speed. And camera speed, I guess.
Yeah.
And maybe I'm a little more sensitive to this right now because I've been sick. But it kind of makes me motion sick.
Oh, yeah, that's fair. If you barf.
So sorry if we went a little while there without camera, like the face cam stuff, because we don't have the most stable cameras.
Nope.
Which, I mean, they're not bad cameras, obviously, but...
Bad camera.
they tend to overheat, and sometimes they don't really tell us that they've overheated, and they just kind of shut down.
Yeah.
And we don't realize until we see a black screen on the little, like, flipped panel, and we're like, oh, wow, that's a thing that happened.
That it is.
But that's what we can afford, so... One thing we haven't talked about is the music and sound effects.
Oh, yeah. So, the music is fun.
It's jazzy?
Yeah, it's like the Marvel vs. Capcom 2 character select.
Okay, I guess that's fair.
Mind you, it's got massively more depth than Marvel vs. Capcom 2 character select, because that was a 10 or 12 second loop.
That's pretty bad.
Gonna take you for a ride. I'm gonna take you for a ride.
That was it. And then it looped back. But no, the music in here is varied, which I like. Well, it's fun.
Is
it's
it
always
varied? Yeah. I think it's only been one song this whole time.
Is it really?
I mean,
this is what happens when we play with this sound loop.
Yeah, our volume is low so that we don't capture it on the microphone, but yeah, I don't know. I mean, I'm not like against the music, and I don't think it's totally out of place. Yeah, I guess I don't really know what I would have done for the music, to be honest.
This is like perfect.
Yeah.
It's got an upbeat sort of tone. You finished it.
I can't stop. Can't stop, won't stop.
Spam clicking.
I've become one with the cat.
The sound effects are simple.
Yeah, they do exactly what they need to do. They don't really feel like they get in the way, and you don't really even realize that they're there, which is generally a good thing with sound effects.
I agree. Oh, hey, we did it.
Yay!
We made it! Yay!
So what's our question of the day for everyone?
We could
pose the same question to them that I asked you just now of, you know, if you were presented the high concept of we're making a cat simulation game.
Oh my god.
This is the question of the day. If you had to make a cat simulation game, and that, you know, pretty much that's all the information that you're given, right? Like, you want to make a cat simulation game, pretty much do with it whatever you want. What would you do? Yeah. Would you do exactly what these guys did, or would you have some other ideas?
If you do have a response to the question of the day, feel free to comment down below.
Yep.
And we'll post the question of the day for those who want to read it instead of hear us say it.
But, yeah, definitely share some thoughts. I personally would love to see what other people would say. Yeah. And I would love to actually kind of discuss what other people think about this game in general, especially if you've played it. This game, we got it off of itch.io, but I think it's actually on a bunch of platforms. Mm. But it's not expensive either, so feel free to check it out.
Definitely check it out. This is fun.
Yeah.
It's mindless, it's senseless, it's goofy, it's fun, it's
very fun. Yeah, I feel like it's a good pick-me-up game, too. If you're ever just like, man, I just want to break a bunch of shit. You're like, I'm gonna be a cat for a while.
Yep. I can't. I'm catting. Did you just try to scan yourself? Oh my god. Now wait, is that the register saying it cannot read, or does that mean that you have a barcode on your ass?
We'll never know. Anyway, bye everybody.
That's all for this episode of Game Devs Play Games. If you have any interesting game requests or any sort of conversations you would like to have, feel free to let us know. Like, comment, and subscribe if you would like to see some more videos from us. And we will see you guys later.
Bye, everybody. Thank you for watching.
See ya.
Does it look okay?
Mm-hmm. I want to look
better than my fucking hair. Look at this shit. I need a haircut.
Oh, memories. I had that, too.